to nibble, baby, please don't bite. It's all right to nibble, baby, please don't bite. You could squeeze me, my darling, but please don't you squeeze too tight. Easy loving, tender touch, that bear hug, honey. Just too much, it's all right to nibble. Baby, please don't bite. You could squeeze me, my darling, but please don't you squeeze too tight. And kissing lick, taking a tease. Watch that grip, honey, when you squeeze. It's all right to nibble. Baby, please don't bite. Squeeze me, my darling, but please don't you squeeze too tight.
Oh,
shopping for a suit the other day and walked into the department store. And I stepped on the elevator and told the girl, said, look here, baby, dry goods flow. So now when I got off, a salesman walked up to me. He said, what can I do for you? I said, well, show me all them sports clothes like you were supposed to do. He said, you know, this year the country's on a continental kick and everybody likes the Latin design. I said, well, do you have? He said, man, we got everything. Clothes is all lined right there. Well, you got it on hand. See, cause I'm going to a party. Got to look as sharp as I can. Now that's when the fella said this, he just did like this. He said, confident dress will be the keynote with a sort of colors toned down to a sheen. He said, picture your seven patch pockets all on little pale silk mohair. Gabardine. He said, hold up 1 minute, check out this new fabric. Just come in, I got here on the shelf. It's an imported lightweight material. Said, traveling on, stand in the mirror and dig yourself. Yes, the very latest of the splash weave with that cutaway flap over twice. It's a box back, two button, wasted modelizer. Ooh, that's real nice. Wrap it up from one time. Well, you got it here on hand. Because I'm going to a party. Got to look as sharp as I can. Oh, you know how I feel, sir. Shades of gray this year with that new knit stitch in the waist. Very latest patterns of plaid, stripes and checks, all that's gonna be in good taste. Now for the businessman, we got the natural shoulder, retail, wholesale at a deal. It's got the custom cuffs and the walking shorts, but I'm gonna let you have it at a steal. I said, look at that. Ooh, fix me up with a charge account. I'll make every repayment like I should. He said, oh, wait 1 minute, just let me check my books and see if we standing good. But then the fella come back and said, I'm sorry, Jack, I can't do no business with you. I said, what you mean, Jelly Bean? He said, yo, credit didn't go through. Wrap it up from one time. Yeah. Well, you got it on hand. See, cause I'm going to a party. Got to look as sharp as I can. Oh boy, look at him, my heart's in pain. Man, they tell me this is the last episode of Can't Stop the Blues, last final installment. And I'd just like to thank Judy and Karen and Daryl and John for and everybody that's been involved in Can't Stop the Blues for doing this, man, and keeping this thing going all year during this pandemic. It's been a real blessing during this time, man. It's been great for us. We get to stay in front of the fans. I get to kick it with my family, aka the Nightcats. It's my, you know, the band gets to hang and play music and do what we do, and it's just been a real godsend. So thank you so much, and we'll see you very soon in person, all right? One, two, three. of the time. What in the world is going through your mind? Why do you say the crazy things you say? What is it makes you wanna act that way? Hey, why you wanna look the way that you do? I said, let me be me. Bust your brains or get you an alphabet behind your name. Diplomas hanging up and down the wall. Don't stop until you think you know it all. But I hope you figure out before you're through to let me be me. And you be you. After, you know, 2020 and all this happening, you know, still, man, we don't get to be out there, and just to hear that lowdown blues sounds good to me. Yeah. Mm. And I know a lot of you ladies, you know, you've been staying home. We all been staying home, and people been, you know, just relaxing at home, and you know, there ain't nothing to do but eat, you know. You know, looking at TV and eating and, you know, putting together jigsaw puzzle, playing video games and eating, you know. And I mean, you know, people get bored and they, you know, frustrated, and they, you know, a lot of times people wanna just eat, you know. And you know, hey, I understand, you know, I understand. And you know, but some of these ladies, I think I've seen it, you know, on Facebook and stuff, they're getting self-conscious about putting on all that weight, you know, and personally, you know, that don't bother me. I like it, man. I like something I can grab onto, something I can, you know, just, and I like to see, you know, see a woman that looks like a woman, man, with some big old, great big, and I'm like, yeah, see. Say, kid.
Hey, what's happening, Rick?
Say, man, you see that one girl over there?
Which girl is that?
Come on, man, ain't but one girl in there. She's 6 feet away from everybody else in the world. Come on.
Oh, man, I thought that was a solar eclipse.
No, come on, you know she looks good.
I'll take the one with the skinny leg.
Nah, me, I like them just like that. That's a baby. Ooh, that's a baby. Man, that's a baby. A whole lot of woman, she sure looks good to me. Now, that's the kind of woman that could steal my heart. So much there, I don't know where to start. I like it like that. Hey, don't you? She got all that meat and them potatoes too. That's big. That's big. Man, that's big. Damn, that's big. Now that's a whole lot of woman. She sure looks good to me. Now look what she got. She got great big hips. She got great big thighs. Just my type, that's my shape and size. Bony little women, they just bruise me up. I let a big fine woman just use me up. And that's big. Ooh, that's big. Man, that's big. Damn, that's big. To be on top, cause that's big. Ooh, that's a big. Man, that's big. Damn, that's big. Now that's a whole lot of woman. She sure looks good to me. Come on, one way, baby. Some people wanna run their mouth. Man, that's one thing I can't figure it out. Oh, you ain't said nothing, just making noise. Look like you're talking just to hear the sound of your own voice. It ain't no need to be lying. And why should we pretend? Just keep your big mouth shut. Oh, but we could all be friends. Hey, you wobble on over, get to shaking my hand. You won't turn me loose, you're squeezing tight as you can. Get me in the corner, start to bump in your gums. I start to looking for the door, I wanna break and run. Ain't no need to be lying. Why should we pretend? Just keep your big mouth shut. Oh, brother, we could all be friends.
All right. Hey guys, so they tell me that this is the last episode of Can't Stop the Blues. Wow, what a cool ride this has been. Thank you, Karen, Judy, Daryl, John, and everyone that's contributed to giving us this saving grace of a platform during such troubled times. You guys made last year more than livable. Some of the most exciting moments ever have been captured forever on Can't Stop the Blues. Thank you guys so much. And thank you for allowing us to put a cap on this amazing platform. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And we'll see you guys out there somewhere soon. Stay safe. Love to you all. Peace.
Now let me ask you something. Now please, it might be a little personal, but I don't want to overstep my bounds. But I just really, really want to know this for myself, and so I'm going to ask you a question, and please be honest. All right? Now, how many people out here and Can't Stop the Blues? How many of you people sitting at home right now have ever been divorced? Huh? Come on, are you ready? Come on, you ever been divorced? Come on. Huh? Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. I mean, I've been divorced. You know, hey, you know, trial and error. Look at kids been divorced. D-Mar's been divorced. D-Mar's like a perfect human being, and even D-Mar's been divorced. Lorenzo, he only looks like a certain perfect human being, but Lorenzo is the only one. He's been married one time only. So that's all, you know. I mean, the jury's still out, you know, but hey, man, divorce, I mean, it's hard, it hurts, it's painful, especially, man, if you're really in love, you know. But the other thing about divorce, it builds character, you know. That's right, man. You have that heartbreaking experience, that just devastating, emotionally devastating experience of having to give up half your shit. You think that don't build character? Yeah, that's right. That's hard. Hard. It's hard. Yeah, man. And the thing about it was really particularly difficult for me because I'm a romantic at heart, you know? I'm a true romantic. I was deeply in love, you know? And it wasn't like we were, you know, had just met or anything like that. We knew each other for quite a while. You know, we had been together already like 5 years before we got married, and everything was cool, man. Everything was cool. We got along great. Then, after 5 years, I finally went, well, we can get married, you know. So we got married. I don't know what happened, man. As soon as we got married, something began to change. Weird, man. Something began to change. And I'll be quite honest with you, it wasn't me. Yeah. But little by little, man, we started bickering, and you know, then pretty soon we're disagreeing on stuff, and we're getting in these little arguments, little spats and things, you know, and then pretty soon we're getting in these full-blown arguments, shouting at each other, screaming at each other. Pretty soon, man, It just degraded, deteriorated till we weren't even speaking at all, man. We just pass each other in the hallway, give each other dirty looks, you know? Rough. But I didn't want to pull the plug, man. I didn't want to give up. Because I, like I said, I believe in true love, man. I really do. And I thought maybe we could work things out. But it just kept getting worse and worse and worse. Finally, one night, we're laying in bed, right? Laying in the bed. It's about 3:34 in the morning. I can still picture it, man. I'm laying there and I'm pissed off. I'm mad, see, I'm just aggravated and I'm too pissed off to sleep. I can't sleep, right? And I'm just laying there, man. I'm staring at the ceiling. I look over at her and she's just all curled up in the fecal position, far as she can get. At the edge, very edge of the bed, the end of the bed, far, far as she can get away from me. She's just all curled up like that, just snoring at the wall. I looked over there. For some reason, I thought about those marriage vows, you know, and I took those marriage vows very seriously. That particular night, I thought of just this one little part. The little portion where they say, till death do us part. I looked over there, I thought, till death do us part, huh? Death. Yeah. But you know what, hey, I'm not entirely stupid. I watch CSI, I watch Forensic Files, First 48, all that type of stuff. I know the first somebody they look at is the husband. That's the first suspect, and they go after you too, man. I mean, they don't play. So right then and there, I decided, man, I got to pull the plug. That's it, man. I got to let this stuff go. And as much as it pained me to be, you know, sacrificing half of everything I had worked for all those years, man. I mean, you know, I just, made me tired just thinking about it. But then I got an idea and I said, you know what? I'm gonna just go ahead and get this divorce. And I'm gonna write a song about her ass and try to recoup like that. So that's what I did. My next ex-wife, look at her. Anything I say, you disagree. Find and fall with me. They don't need to tell, I can read the signs. Yeah, I might be crazy, but I ain't blind. I see you sleeping all day, staying out late night. Got a feeling like I'm dealing with my next ex-wife. Never in the mood. When I ask you why you cop an attitude, and you ain't well, only thing you do, live around all day. Hey, complaining about you tired, now how'd you get that way? Oh, you keep telling me I'm wrong, but something ain't right. Got a feeling like I'm dealing with my next ex-wife. Oh, yeah. keep getting married and I keep getting burned. Count so much to untie some line that they want half of the half of a half I still got on. I'll be paying the price. Got a feeling like I'm dealing with my next ex-wife. We'll be right back. Like the sun come out, and every time we love, I love her more and more. When I walk, toe, walk, I want. Praise the Lord, I got a new old lady, so doggone good to me. Makes my old, old lady another but ancient history. That she don't love you, cause buddy, that little girl is making money too. I got a new old lady, so doggone good to me. Makes my old, old lady nothing but ancient history. I hear you, kid, come on. Sorry that she don't love you, but brother, that little girl is making money too. I got a new old lady, so doggone good to me. Makes my old, old lady nothing but ancient history.
One and none don't make two. You got
got to generate some revenue. It's cool that you tell me that you love me too, but you got to have a job. You got to help me up, don't hold me back. You got to add and don't subtract. It might sound cold, but it's just the facts. You got to have a job.
What if she's big and fat?
Man, I'm cool with that.
What if she's extra thin?
Hey, include me in. It's just one type of chick that I strictly avoid.
Unemployed!
Now, I'm trying hard to make ends meet. I'm trying to keep my booty out of the street. I need cars and clothes and steaks to eat. So you got to have a job. No more free rides, you got to have a job. Girl, yeah, you know what? Hey, I've been through that routine before, and I ain't nobody's mule no more. From now on, I'm keeping score. You got to have a job.
What if her teeth are missing?
Man, that's good for kissing.
What if she's got a mustache?
Or does she have any cash? It's just one type of chick that I strictly avoid. Like your mama did, lay up and watch TV and just watch the kids telling you now just like it is. You got to have a job. Yeah, sure. Got to have a job, baby. That's all to it. Got to have a job. Man, it's 2021. Don't you know that times are hard, and then times are especially hard for musicians, and I'm just a harmonica player. I mean, then nobody needs one of those, right? So, you know, and that stimulus check, that was pretty cool for about a week and a half, but that don't get it. And you keep saying you're gonna get a job, but I don't see no evidence of it, because hey, you know, all I know is this. Every day I come home, I get home, there you are, same thing. Every day, same deal, man. You're in your regular position, laying up on the couch, got an old ratty bathrobe on, house shoes, rag tied around your head. And here's what makes me mad too. You gotta, cause you claim to be looking for a job, checking the want ads and all that, but the evidence is clear. You got a remote control in one hand, and then you got a joint in the other hand, talking about, gee, honey, the job situation don't look too good. I don't care, I don't want to hear it. Get out and get yourself a job.
That's what I was supposed to play. Okay, good. That'll work.
Fuck it, yeah.
Yeah.
I want to send a big thank you to everyone at Can't Stop the Blues. Everyone behind the scenes and all the fans tuning in every week, because you guys have been keeping live music alive during the COVID times. So, thank you.